Hi guys, hallo Leute, welcome back to German with Jenny. In this video, I'd like to talk to you about relative clauses. A relative clause provides additional information about a noun in a sentence. Let's take a closer look at how this works. First example, ich trinke Kaffee, der aus Ecuador kommt. I'm drinking coffee that comes from Ecuador. So you see that der is the English that or which, or it can also be who. In this sentence, we have a main clause, ich trinke Kaffee, and we also have a relative clause, der aus Ecuador kommt. You may notice that the verb is at the end of that clause, because relative clauses are subordinate clauses. In a relative clause, we have a relative pronoun, which is der in this case. And the relative pronoun refers back to the noun in the main clause. Der refers back to Kaffee. And it's der, it's masculine, because Kaffee is masculine. Der is also the subject of the relative clause. Second example. Ich trinke Kaffee, den ich gestern gekauft habe. So we have the main clause, ich trinke Kaffee, and we have the relative clause, den ich gestern gekauft habe. You may notice that we're not using der, but we're using den this time. That's because den is in the accusative case, because in the relative clause, the subject is ich. I was the one who bought coffee. I have the active part. It's not the coffee, but it's me. I have the active part. And that's why ich is the subject and den is the direct object. And that's why we have to use den and not der. Let's compare these two sentences again. Ich trinke Kaffee, der aus Ecuador kommt. Der is the subject of that clause. The coffee comes from Ecuador. The coffee is the active part here. In the second sentence, ich trinke Kaffee, den ich gestern gekauft habe. The coffee is not the active part anymore. I was the one who bought the coffee. Ich habe den Kaffee gekauft. I had the active part. And the coffee was the thing that I bought. So the coffee has to be the direct object. Next example. Ich trage eine Jacke, die keine Kapuze hat. I'm wearing a jacket that doesn't have a hood. Ich trage eine Jacke, die keine Kapuze hat. So in this relative clause, we're using die, because we're referring back to Jacke, and Jacke is feminine, so we have to use die. And die is the subject. The jacket does not have a hood. The jacket is the active part. That's the subject of that clause. Next example. Ich habe Angst vor Spinnen, die sehr haarig sind. I'm afraid of spiders that are very hairy. So in this relative clause, we're using die. And die refers back to spiders, to Spinnen. Spinnen is plural. That's why we have to use die, the plural article die. Next example. Ich lese ein Buch, das mir Janosch empfohlen hat. Das is the relative pronoun here, and it refers back to Buch. Buch is neutral, so we have to use das. Next example. Ich lese ein Buch, das im Regal stand. I'm reading a book that was on the shelf. Ich lese ein Buch, das im Regal stand. The book was on the shelf. This is the subject. This is the active part. So we have to use das, the nominative case. Next example. Ich trage eine Jacke, die ich online gekauft habe. I'm wearing a jacket that I bought online. So in this relative clause, ich is the subject. I bought the jacket. I have the active part. Next example. Ich habe Angst vor den Spinnen, die mein Vater eben nach draußen getragen hat. I'm afraid of the spiders that my dad just carried outside. So mein Vater is the subject in this clause. He has the active part. He carried the spiders outside. He's the subject. And so die is in the accusative case. Now let's take a look at some more examples. Ich habe eben mit einer Freundin telefoniert, die ich in Berlin kennengelernt habe. We're using die, because Freundin is feminine. The subject here is ich. I met the friend. I have the active part. Die Stiefel, die ich auf Aweso bestellt habe, bestehen aus recyceltem Material. The boots that I ordered on Aweso consist of recycled material. I'm the one who ordered the boots, so I'm the subject. And die is in the accusative case, because the boots are the thing that I bought. Die Stiefel, die gestern im Schaufenster standen, haben mir gefallen. The boots that were in the shop window yesterday were appealing to me, which means I liked the boots that were in the shop window yesterday. Die is the relative pronoun, and it's the subject. It's in the nominative case. Der Arzt, der mich behandelt hat, wohnt in der Nachbarschaft. The doctor who treated me lives in the neighborhood. Der is the relative pronoun, and it refers to Arzt. It's the subject. Der Arzt, den ich dir empfohlen habe, ist Dermatologe. The doctor who I recommended to you is a dermatologist. I was the one recommending, so I am the subject. And the doctor is the direct object. So we use den. Der Mann, der gerade ins Auto gestiegen ist, ist mein Nachbar. The man who just got into his car is my neighbor. Der Mann, der gerade ins Auto gestiegen ist, ist mein Nachbar. So the man who got in the car, he's the subject. He got into his car. And so der is in the nominative case. Die Unterlagen, die ich morgen dem Chef geben muss, liegen auf meinem Schreibtisch. The documents that I have to give to my boss tomorrow are on my desk. I have to give the documents to my boss. Ich. Ich is the subject here. Die Unterlagen, die auf meinem Schreibtisch liegen, muss ich morgen ins Büro mitnehmen. I have to take the documents that are on my desk to the office tomorrow. Die Unterlagen, die auf meinem Schreibtisch liegen, muss ich morgen ins Büro mitnehmen. Das sind die Handtücher, die ich im Internet bestellt habe. These are the towels that I ordered online. Das sind die Handtücher, die ich im Internet bestellt habe. Das sind die Handtücher, die Vera mir geschenkt hat. These are the towels that Vera gave to me as a present. Das sind die Handtücher, die Vera mir geschenkt hat. Die Frau, die mir geholfen hat, heißt Christina Müller. The woman who helped me is called Christina Müller. Her name is Christina Müller. Die Frau, die mir geholfen hat, heißt Christina Müller. All right, now you know how relative clauses work. When there's a relative pronoun in the nominative case and when there's a relative pronoun in the accusative case. Next time we'll talk about relative pronouns in the dative case. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss!